Okay, it's Christopher Mader from the Meat and Potato Show. I'm talking to Ronal Madnick. Do I have your name right? And we're here at the NDAA protest here on the 12th of July behind City Hall. And Ron, you were at both of the City Hall meetings, if I'm not mistaken. That's right. And you were the one that wrote the resolution and presented it to it. So go ahead. Yeah, go ahead and give your statement there.
Now, the thing is here is that it's clear that while perhaps the majority on the city council agree with us as individuals, the majority is not willing to vote on the issue as a city council. That's our problem. They think the only things the city council should vote on are things directly under their control, for example, like paving a street. They did sort of indicate, at least one or two councilors, if we could come back and prove that a Worcester citizen was actually damaged by this legislation.
That was Connie Luke's statement, I remember, yeah.
That's Connie Luke's. The problem is what the government does is in secret. So even if the government was doing it, it is very unlikely they would know about it unless somebody like Edward Snowden, who had the information, released it to the general public. Now the second thing is that it was called the reauthorization of the National Defense Act. When President Obama signed it, he said he would not carry out one provision of it, which would allow the incarceration of Americans without charges or trial by jury. This, I suppose, is under what we call an executive order. Now the problem is that Obama could change his mind tomorrow. The second problem is it is the law of the United States, and our future president could decide to carry it out. So as long as it's on the books, we all are in danger.
Excellent. Thank you very much, sir.